Hello, Grade 7. Welcome back to KIS Online. It's me, Sir Joey, and I will be your teacher for this week. Before we proceed with our lesson, let's recall our previous lesson. So last week, we had listening skills, and it's all about days and dates. We got listening 1, 2, 3, and 4. I know that's hard for you, but we have to try. And I congratulate you for doing your best for finishing all the listening skills. This week, we will continue with our Unit 4. Still, it's all about days and dates, but we will focus on our language. This week, we will learn present simple, and we will focus on affirmative. Affirmative means it's a positive. It's a positive statement. So that's present simple, affirmative. Now, when to use present simple? Again, this is a review. We had this before. So I want you to answer while I'm asking, okay? Now, when to use present simple? I give you here 6 sentences. I'll read sentence number 1. I walk to school every morning. And Rudy plays tennis at 5 o'clock on Tuesdays. So number 1, we use present simple to talk about routines or habits. For example, the things we usually do every day or every week. Again, we use present simple to talk about daily routines or habits. With our example, the things that we do every day or every week. So that's number 1. We use present simple for number 2 when we describe the things that are always true. Let me read. My father speaks English. It's always true. We study Chinese, and that's always true. That's why we use present simple. 5th and 6th sentences. He thinks the festival is exciting. He thinks. Last sentence, she likes music. Now, we use present simple to talk about what we think, we feel, or like. So, that's the usage of present simple. Understand? Now, if you have questions, just drop in our chat box. I can answer the same day. So now, we'll proceed on our rules. I will write here on the bottom. Now, take a look. We got pronoun I, we. So, in summary, I, we, you, they. We use, take a look, with S or without S? No S. We study, no S. Therefore, we use the base form of the verb. Base form of the verb. No S, no ES, no IES. Okay, what about singular noun or pronouns he, she? He, she, it. Okay, this goes 3 rules. Simply, with a verb, singular noun or singular pronoun, we add S. We add S. We add S. And also, we add es. So there are verbs that ends with sh, ends with ch, or ends with o. We put es, es, es. Okay? And lastly, we use singular pronoun he, she, it, or singular subject. We add ies for verbs that ends with y. Change y to I and add es. Remember, verbs that ends with y, change y to I and add es. So we got 1, 2, 3. All right. I hope you learned something for our review unit. And again, if you have questions, drop your comment right away. Ask today. And I will definitely answer your question. Okay? So that ends with our lesson number one for this week. And on our next video will be your exercise number one. Thank you for watching and see you on next video. God bless everyone and bye.